and my book is called Passionate Prayer. I really enjoyed this, and I now know that I need to go back through it again, especially in these times of being home and isolated from everyone and not having church together, that I need to feed my soul every day with something different. So I hope you enjoy the great peace of God. Be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all comprehension, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Philippians 4:6-7. Prayer is God's prescription for a troubled heart. The more you pray, the more you experience God's peace. Peace is passionate prayer's great result. Paul encouraged the suffering church of Philippi, be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all comprehension, will guard your heart and your minds in Christ Jesus. If you are worried or anxious, you must pray. If you are angry, you must pray. If you are bitter, you must pray. If you are fearful, you must pray. The heart's deepest troubles require your most passionate prayers. God's peace will stand as a guard over the heart, patrolling every door of entry and blocking all worry, anxiety, anger, and fear. Oh, what a defining moment when we may experience when we take all fear, worry, bitterness, and anger and lay it all at the feet of the Yahweh Shalom. The Lord is peace. The New Testament word phrase translated peace is Irene and refers to tranquility based on a sense of divine favor. When storms rage in your heart, follow the example of the disciples who were with their Lord on the stormy Sea of Galilee. Fearing for their lives, thinking their boat would sink, they cried out to Jesus. He said to them, "Why are you afraid, you men of little faith?" Then he got up and rebuked the winds and the sea, and it became perfectly calm. Matthew 8:25. Imagine the Lord bringing the same calmness to your heart and commanding the tempest in your soul to be still. The peace of God leads to the greatest satisfaction and contentment one can have in life. God's peace, rest, tranquility, and sense of safety to the heart. And so, what must we do when worry, fear, bitterness, or anger come knocking on the door of our hearts and minds? We must pray. The context of the fourth chapter of Philippians is important in understanding how we must pray. Paul has just informed the church that the Lord is near, Philippians 4:5. This may be interpreted as realized and future eschatology. The Lord is ever present and coming again, yay. Walking and talking with the Lord depends on his presence in your life. God's presence brings a question to our minds. Why would we need to tell God the details of our lives when he already knows what we need? Telling him draws us near into the heavenly courts of the Lord himself as we spread our cares before him, lifting us up above temporal and inviting us to breathe in the air of an eternal perspective. Hezekiah learned to present his troubles to the Lord by spreading out an intimidating letter from the king of Assyrians, 2 Kings 19:14, Isaiah 37:14-15. Threatened with destruction of Jerusalem, Hezekiah had to choose to believe the gods of his enemy or to live in the presence of one true God. We make a similar decision. Our outlook can move from despair to hope and from dread to expectation. The way to be anxious about nothing is to be prayerful about everything. When God invites you to pray about everything, he is implying that no need is too small to take to him. Paul encourages to add thanksgiving to our conversation with God. The Greek word translated thanksgiving is Eucharistia, and in this context refers to gratitude to God. The word Eucharist is used in our language for communion, our celebration of thanksgiving for the sacrifice of Christ. Paul is encouraging the Philippian church to be thankful in everything. How can we be thankful to God when our hearts are not in the mood? When your heart is broken and crushed, just about the last expression you feel is gratitude. I firmly believe our thankfulness to God, especially in difficult times, is by a faith, prayer based on who God is and what He does and what He says in His Word. Thankfulness acknowledges truth beyond that which I know and feel. My gratitude acknowledges God's behind-the-scenes work in the world and in my life. Sometimes what He is doing is imminently visible, but other times it is not apparent. But what if He is doing the most marvelous and amazing work invisible to our eyes? Often that is exactly the case. And so let us say, thank You, Lord. You are awesome and incredible. Let us not be unaware, like Jacob, who finally said, surely the Lord is in this place, and I did not know it. Genesis 28:16. Always remember, dear friends, God is never worried, anxious, or fearful. He knows what you need even before you ask, Matthew 6:8. And He promises to supply all your needs, Philippians 4:19. Why do we ever worry? Why do we become anxious? These questions seem absurd to us because we could probably list at least 1,000 reasons why, especially right now, today, right? But Jesus must wonder why His children are constantly worried and prone to anxiety when He knows the provision of the Father for our needs. He encourages us not to worry about what we will eat, what we will wear, where we will live, or even the pressure and passage of time. Matthew 6:25-34, Jesus says, your heavenly Father knows that you need all things. Matthew 6:32, implying He will provide for our basic needs in life. I thank You so much, and I'd like to end us today in prayer with a poem, and it's called Be Not Afraid. So let's pray. You shall walk the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak Your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of God and live. If you pass through raging waters, in the sea you shall not drown. If you walk amid the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand before the power of hell and the death is at your side, know that I am with you through it all. Blessed are your poor, for the kingdom shall be theirs. Blessed are you that weep and mourn, for one day you shall laugh. And if wicked tongues insult and hate you all because of me, blessed are you. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come follow me, and I will give you rest. In Jesus' name, amen. And Lord be with all of you and in your hearts, and keep you calm and not to fear until we meet again. Thank you.